the root test does not work that often, but if it works, it works very fast. And often, it's then often the only test which is easy to apply. In this video, we will encounter two examples. So, first example, we have an awkward AN. 2n plus 3 divided by 3n plus 2 to the power n. We want to determine convergence or divergence of the series. Well, let's see what happens if we apply the root test. Well, our AN looks horrible, but if we take the nth power of the absolute value, it looks much better because then this n over here cancels us out and we get just 2n plus 3 over 3n plus 2. And for the root test, we only need to take the limit of n to infinity of 2n plus 3 over 3n plus 2. Well, that's easy, divide by n, then you get 2 plus 3 over n divided by 3 plus 2 over n. You can take use the quotient rule and the sum rule, and you get 2 over 3, which is smaller than 1, which means that our original series is absolutely convergent. So, there we are. Before we start on the second example, we need a slight generalization of the root test, and for that we need the notion of the lim sub. So, what is that? Well, the lim sub of n to infinity of a sequence cn equals l, what does that mean? Well, then this l is the smallest number you can think of, such that for any epsilon bigger than zero, if you are far enough, so there exists a capital N, such that all cn are below this l plus epsilon. So it's slightly weaker than the notion of a limit. If you have a limit, if you go far enough, then your terms are in the interval L and a plus minus epsilon around it. So all your points are very close to L. This is a bit weaker. This only says that if you look from above, you get in an interval L epsilon, or you can be further below. So the lim sub is in that sense a bit weaker notion. How do you use it? Well, let's look at 3 plus minus 1 to the power n. So what happens over here with this sequence? The minus 1 to the power n equals plus or minus 1, so we get 3 plus or minus 1. So the sequence has as terms 2, 4, 2, 4, 2, 4, 2, 4. It does not converge, does not have a limit. What is the lim sub? Well, it's the smallest value, which is above all numbers of the sequence. You can think of that, think of it like that roughly. So the lim sub is not equal to 5, because you can find a smaller value, 4.5, which is above all values of the sequence. Lim sub is not 3, because it's not above all values of the sequence. You already guess what the lim sub is. It equals 4 in this case, because then it's above all values of the sequence and you cannot find a smaller value. Do something similar with the cosine of n. If you take that sequence, well, they are on the function of the cosine, so they are oscillating around between minus 1 and 1. Limit does not exist, but the lim sub equals 1 because all values are of the sequence are below that and it's the smallest value. And if your limit exists, lim sub of 1 over n, it's just then your lim sub is just the same as the limit, it equals 0. Because if you get far enough, you get arbitrarily close to this 0. So, why do we need this lim sub? Well, we can use it for our root test, for example in this one. Sum 1 to infinity, 3 plus minus 1 to the power n to the power n divided by 5 to the power n. Notice that this is not an alternating series. What happens if we try to apply the root test? Well, we have an equals 3 plus minus 1 to the power n divided by 5 to the power n. If we apply the root test, then this n over here cancels out. So we get 3 plus minus 1 to the power n over 5. But now we have to take the limit n to infinity. But fortunately for the root test, the lim sub is already sufficient. So lim sub, limit n to infinity does not exist. Lim sub does exist of this quantity we just computed over here. We get 4 over 5, which is smaller than 1, which means that the series over here is absolutely convergent. So now you see two examples where you can apply the root test. If you can just compute the limit, it goes really, really fast. And even if you have to apply the lim sub, still you can use the root test to determine whether your series is convergent or divergent.